It ain't about how hard you hit. It's about how hard you can get hit and keep moving forward.
Who was the greatest? Who was the best of all time?
If a philosopher and a monster could fight, who would be the winner? In one corner, the reigning champ, Thomas Hobbes, would be pitted against Frankenstein's monster. Computer animations say that the monster would win.
You know, I'm naturally good at heart. They'll believe me, right?
No, they won't.
Yeah, they will. I'm so good.
He's a philosopher. They'll never believe you.
That computer fight got a lot of people curious.
Yeah, but I ain't interested in getting, like, mangled and embarrassed.
People are gonna think you're going crazy.
What's crazy about standing toe-to-toe saying I am?
If this is something that you gotta do, then you do it.
I can do it!
Come on, hard right. Come on.
We are here today with Frankenstein's monster to talk to them about his upcoming fight against Thomas Hobbes. Tell us a little about your history.
Well, I was created by Victor Frankenstein. I had lots of parts to different people, and he brought me to life using lightning.
What did you do after you were created?
I went in the woods. I found some people, and they didn't like me, so I ran away.
So what's your philosophy on human nature?
I think people are good, because I like doing good things.
What do you think about Thomas Hobbes' theory?
I think it's stupid, because he thinks people are bad, but I do good things for people, like chop wood, remove snow, and get food.
What people do you help?
Realists!
Thank you, Mr. Frankenstein.
I wanna help you!
$6 million? Are you kidding me? No!
Feels good.
Tell them I won't take
you.
Anything less than 10 million. It's not my fault that people are naturally evil. I don't have time to listen to this. Go deal with it yourself. Sorry about that.
Hello. Today we are interviewing Thomas Hobbes before his big fight against the monster. So Hobbes, tell us a little bit about yourself.
Well, I was born in 1588 into a relatively poor family in Wiltshire. There I attended school at Oxford University, where I excelled as a linguist, poet, and translator. In 1640, I had to flee to France to avoid the turmoil preceding the Civil War. I stayed there until about 1651. Due to my controversial writings, especially the Leviathan, I was in danger of being prosecuted after Charles II was restored.
So what were some things occurring during your lifetime?
Well, this was around the time of Galileo, Isaac Newton, and Kepler. So Galileo had just made his telescope, and Kepler was making his three laws.
So what's your theory on human nature?
Well, I learned during the Civil War that humans are naturally evil. They're born that way. They're out to do anything to benefit themselves and get whatever they want.
So do you think the monster is wrong?
Of course he's wrong. As I said, through my studies I've learned that all people are naturally evil. He was obviously just acting to try and get some kind of gain.
Thank you.
Why is this billed as an exhibition?
So they wouldn't have to call it an execution.
It takes guts climbing back in that ring knowing you're gonna take a beating.
You were born bad.
I was born good.
You were born bad.
I was born naturally good.
Are you naturally good enough?